Welcome back to the adventure. This is Adam, and today we're going to be talking about IDE cables. Don't click away just yet. Some of this information may be useful. I would like to take a look at this sound card that we have been using in our system. It has these pins for an IDE cable to connect to it, but there isn't a black plastic guard around it like you may see with some other cards. That is also true for the system that we've been using. The motherboard doesn't have the black plastic guards around the pins either. This means that it is possible to put the cable on in both directions. Putting the cable on backwards shouldn't damage the drive connected to it, but the system won't be able to complete the power on self-test. If the power does turn on, the system won't boot. You will either get beep codes or a blank black screen. So if the cable can go on both directions, how do you know which way is the right way? On the sound card, there is a mark in the upper right-hand corner with a number 1 on it. That indicates pin number 1 on the sound card. On the IDE cable, there's this red strip on the side. That's telling you what side should connect to pin number 1. Another iteration of IDE cable, like this one I have here, has this spot over pin number 20. That's to prevent you from putting the cable on the wrong direction. The problem is that with our sound card, all 40 pins are there. So this cable actually won't work with the sound card. Despite that limitation, I love this IDE cable. It was actually a donation by a friend of the channel. I just love the way that it's braided, and somebody took a lot of time to put this together, or it was done by a machine very quickly. Either way, I really like this cable. It's unique, and I only have the 2 in my collection, although I'm sure these were mass-produced. Also looks very cool inside the case and makes cable management quite a bit easier. Next, we have a card like this that does have the black plastic guards around the pins, so the cable can only go on one direction. Pretty simple. With the cable, there's this ridge or bump right up here in the middle. That just gets lined up with this opening here on the card, and it connects right in. Now, this is an ATA 133 card. It's a later revision of IDE than what the sound card is capable of. It has a much faster data transfer rate. However, you need an 80 conductor cable to take advantage of that. If we take a look at this, here is a 40 conductor IDE cable. It's called that because there are 40 wires running through it. And here we have an example of an 80 conductor cable. There are 80 wires running through it. However, there's still the same 40 pins available for IDE. The reason why there's twice as many wires in the cable is so communication can go both directions at the same time. That was a problem with the earlier revisions of IDE, or I should say, to get the faster transfer rate, the bottleneck became the IDE cable. And there's a comparison of the two cables side by side. All right, that concludes our look at IDE cables. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.